The nut with the camera.
I don't think we're shy.
This is Uncle Paul's dinner before the services.
Keep it my mom, baby. Keep it my dad. Rainbow with my dad.
And this is Misty's husband,
and then,
Mark.
He's
you guys, I don't know any of you, so just kind of pop off your names, and then you're going to get to sign a waiver saying that you agree to be on YouTube, because this is going to be on YouTube by this evening and be published. It'll be on there by tomorrow night. And that way y'all can download it any on your computers. It's a free download. Now, who are you ladies?
I'm a friend.
Hi.
This is Marge.
Hey, it's a little camera with a big lens, I'll tell you. Hello.
I'm a skip-bo buddy.
Do y'all know Bertha Porter and John Ralph Porter?
No.
Well,
I'm Mandy. I'm Beta's daughter.
And you look very familiar, so I know you know John Ralph, and you've probably bumped into me a time or two. You sure look familiar.
She doesn't know who John Ralph is.
Okay. Well, have you been to any of the McCullough reunions down in Arnett or Shattuck or anything?
Must be my beautiful twin.
Okay, and who are you guys over here?
Oh, I'm Leo Dell. This is my wife, Kim.
And I'm Lou Nichols, a friend.
Okay.
Audrey Alexander, favorite.
And who are you, beautiful?
Got my mouth full.
Oh, see, I tried to avoid that, because then I know y'all would be hammering me if I caught somebody eating, or my wife would do it for you, see.
Yeah.
She always tells everybody that they're welcome to carry a baseball bat and beat me with it.
Oh.
She's always telling people that. Ladies, I didn't mean to try to get y'all eating, so I'm just going to buzz through here. How y'all doing?
And then you are?
I am John Ralph's son, Johnny Ray. And you are? All right. So y'all are helping serve food and all that. It's wonderful. This is really wonderful. Who are you ladies? Are y'all any relations?
No.
See, all of us cousins, we don't even know each other.
And is that my mother, right?
Okay. Well, we got somebody over here that's related.
That's our pastor.
Oh, and this here?
This is our pastor.
Awesome. Well, it's wonderful to meet you, and it's a wonderful facility y'all have here, and thank you for putting up with all of us. And I'm one of the great nephews, and if any of these guys know me, I'm always the one pulling out the cameras and taking the pictures. And thank y'all. Okay, now y'all are safe. Yeah, there we go. I'm going to sit down here and eat my dinner. Hi, Tom. I'm Johnny, Poor Joe Trucker. And so you guys know Misty?
Forever.
And a little bit longer than forever then, huh?
Longer than forever.
And give me just one memory with Misty and her granddad.
Oh, Zuno. Or, what's it?
Zuno.
No. They always love to play cards every Sunday.
Oh.
I don't remember. What is that card game that they play?
Skip-bo.
Skip-bo.
Well, they like to play Skip-bo. I know that
Skip-bo
one.
Skip-bo every Sunday.
Well, isn't that awesome?
I play so many different card games, it's hard to remember Skip-bo, because it's a long time ago game.
Well, did they ever play Uno?
No, they just play Skip-bo.
Yeah, that's a good game. I love Skip-bo.
He was the only woman around a table of women.
The only man.
The only man?
The only
yeah.
Table full of women.
Now say, surprise, Misty. This is your surprise interview that you haven't seen yet, but you're going to get to see this on YouTube.
Surprise, Misty. You're going to make all my boo-boos come out.
Yeah. This is an unedited, unscripted video on YouTube. Hi, everybody. Yeah. Misty's limo, and the driver's fixing to let Misty in the car, and Misty's mother.
The whole seven, Johnny. I think we'll fix it up front with the driver.
I get to sit up front with the driver. Misty's mom. This is Misty's husband, Mark. Uncle Philip McCullough's funeral procession. Everybody's lining up out here. We're all getting out of it. Thank you, limo driver. She wants me to get further. Here's Uncle Phillips.
Do y'all want to take that home?
Oh, she, I'm sure would love it.
Do you want to take it
home?
Yes, please. I'll pull it out after the service.
Okay.
Okay?
All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
Love you, Uncle Philip.
I just wanted to bring it up here so bad that I just, my life and God.
Recognize that guy. I've seen him around somewhere. We're going to have to quit meeting like this.
We've got to stop and start talking.
Because the Bible says that we are allotted 70 years. But by reason of strength, some will make it to 80. And look what he did. He surpassed that and went on to live 88 wonderful years. And right up until almost, I think they said 2 months before, he had really pretty good health. And so his life is a victorious life, a triumphant life. Like all of us, he was less than perfect. We all are. But he lived a life that brought so much glory and honor to God and then his family. And so I'm feeling honored today to be with you here as we celebrate his life. Let us pray together. Almighty Father, we welcome you into our service today. Thank you, King Jesus. Sir, we are glad to have you here today and always feel your presence, but more so now at a time like this. We ask that you would just bless us today as we remember the man, and then, Father, help us to remember the wonderful creation that you gave to him. Thank you, Lord, that you make us all differently and that we're not clones, but we're made in a wonderful, precise way, Lord. But we are glad that we can today say another soul is home to be with you. Praise you, Heavenly Father, and thank you for the time we're spending here today together. In Jesus' name, amen. From the Bible all the time. Anytime you open the Bible, you can be so down or so despondent or depressed, so blue, and God will lift you up. And I like that. Today, you know, we're just temporarily sad because we know that, yes, we're going to miss him. No one can take Philip's place. No one ever can when you have a loved one like that. But temporarily, we're not going to see him, but eventually here, probably closer than we think, we're going to be together and see him. There's going to be unity when we get to see him again. It's going to be a great reunion. So I'm so thankful that God cheers us up when we're down. It says over in the red letter edition, John 11, 25 and 26, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth on me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. believest on this. So we do. We believe that because he said that. And he means what he says and says what he means. Then it tells us over in 2 Corinthians 1, 3 and 4. Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of all mercies, the God of all comfort, who comforts us in our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith we are comforted of God. So this is one of those things that God simply says, pass it along. You're comforted. You feel better. You are able to go on. You have a good outlook. Someone's patted you on the back. Someone's given you strength to go on. Someone's saying you can do it. He says, pass that along to somebody else. And that's what we're doing here today. We're simply saying that, yes, we love this man. And there's a void in our life. And we could feel pretty futile, and have a lot of futility in our life. But he says, yes, you can go on. And so I say to Mark and Misty and the family and all the wonderful family friends here, you can go on because God said it was okay, that you're going to be all right. Well, then the family simply said, and everybody likes this, the shepherd's psalm, Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. May God bless the reading of the Holy Scriptures.
I draw the closer to him.
2011. He passed away Tuesday, August 16, 2011, in Amarillo, Texas. Mr. McCullough was born on December 11, 1922, in Arnett, Oklahoma, to John and Ora McCullough. He graduated from Arnett High School in 1941. He married Beatrice Carpenter in 1942. And she preceded him in death in 1982. Mr. McCullough served in the U.S. Navy from 1941 until he was honorably discharged in 1945. He moved to Amarillo in 1952 from Nebraska and went to work for Southwestern Public Service as a lineman until his retirement in 1984. Let me just pause right there. Known several people that were linemen, some young men that I know today that are linemen. And I was telling Misty and Mark yesterday that linemen are, you've got to be pretty sharp to be a lineman. You've also got to have a lot of courage. And I know they've got mechanized equipment now, and it's easier, but I tell you what, linemen are a pretty rough breed of people. They have to go out when sometimes the conditions aren't the easiest, the elements are bad, and they have to be under emergency restrictions at all times, and it's a place where you can get hurt really bad and even lose your life. So a lineman has to be a different type of person, a good worker, and have to know what they're doing and have to have courage. And I really respect him. And so when I heard he was a lineman, I thought, my heart goes out to him. And he was that in that business until his retirement in 1984. Mr. McCullough enjoyed traveling, camping, playing skip-ball. Boy, he loved that skip-ball. You don't know how many thousands of games he played. And some of you right here grinned and kind of nodded because he was probably played with you and against you. But I bet he was good at it, wasn't he? Very, very good at what he did there. And he probably didn't like to lose. You know, he's probably pretty competitive, wasn't he? He was preceded in death by his wife, Beatrice, and his second wife, Elva, a daughter, Phyllis Catherall, three brothers and two sisters. He was a member of Second Baptist Church and of the VFW. Now, I understand that Charlie Jones was one of his dear friends. He loved Charlie Jones. Pretty hard not to like Charlie Jones. I like him. I've known him for a long time. He gives me a hard time. In fact, he's a couple of jokes up on me and practical jokes up on me. And I need to get back at him some way or another. Please help me. See me after the service if you know something we can do to Charlie. He's a good fellow. I've known him and Francis for a long time, and they just don't come any better than the Jones people. He will be greatly missed by all who knew him. He is survived by his granddaughter, Misty Hubert, and husband Mark of Amarillo, great-granddaughter, Michelle Hubert of Amarillo, great-grandson, Diego Hubert of Amarillo, three brothers, Victor McCullough of California, Paul McCullough of Oklahoma, and Joseph McCullough of Kansas, and a special friend, Veda Odell of Amarillo. Veda, are you here today? Right there, okay. I had heard so many nice things about you, and they said you were just a go-getter, and you knew how to just encourage him, and said you were really a sharp lady, and I believe that. And so they said you might have something you wanted to say today. Later on, we're going to talk about him. If you've got some thoughts, because they said that kind of indicated that maybe you weren't bashful or anything, and you might want to say some things about your friend Philip. And so I'll just invite you later on. I won't put you on the spot. Hope I haven't. But if you want to say something later on, that'd be fine. We would welcome that. But you might have some good stories about him or something. So if you feel like doing that, you go ahead and do that. Well, anyway, many friends here. And is there anybody here today from the hospice that is representing the hospice? Raise your hand if you're from there. Okay, they are God's angels. You know what I always say? They're God's angels on earth. Boy, they do good work. And they are good at comforting people, and I'm just always so appreciative of the people from hospice, whether it be Odyssey or BSA. They're all good, or they wouldn't be there. And so I just thank God for those dear people and just love them so much. But we're going to have another song at this time. We sure have some good songs.
This is Uncle Philip coming out of the casket, and he actually has a military Navy honor guard here, which is just awesome. I could have jumped in there, I guess, as another pallbearer. I didn't realize I could do that. If I wasn't bearing the camera, I would.
What we do is we just simply say ashes to ashes, dust to dust, dust and earth to earth. But we look forward to that great resurrection when his body and all of our bodies will be incorruptible. You see, right today, as we come out here in this cemetery, this is not a very pretty sight. It's nobody's fault, except we just haven't had the rain or the moisture. But we'll get that too eventually. And as you come out here, Mark and Misty and others, love this man. You know what? He'll just simply be here and there'll be a body, but he won't be here. Because as quick as he passed away, as quick as he took his last breath, his spirit winged its way to be with the Lord. And all we have is here today the body. It's served.
him so well. It was just like a house. But now he has just went on because that body served him 88 years, and it was a good body, but it is decayed now, and so his spirit is with the Lord. And you know what? This is the beginning. A lot of people say when we come out to the cemetery, this is the end. No, this is the beginning of eternity for Philip. And so he'd just go on forever and ever and ever. Why? Because he's with the Lord. And that's where we want to be. I'm kind of envious all the time when I come out here and everything. I thought, you know, when's my turn going to be? Well, it's coming. It's coming for all of us. And so today we just simply come out here and we're so happy for him. Sad for ourselves that we got to go through this world like this. But we have joy too, because there's joy in the Lord. So our main service was at the chapel. This is pretty brief out here. I simply want to have a prayer and bless the family, and then you can stay and mingle if you want to. Almighty Father, I thank you today for the opportunity to come here and know, dear Lord, that this is just a resting spot. It's just a place to be until the Lord comes back. And the Bible says that he'll come back with a shout, with the voice of an archangel. And Father, that the dead in Christ shall rise first, and then those of us who are left behind shall rise to meet you in the air. Thank you for that promise, Father, forevermore. And we know, Heavenly Father, that heaven's a great place, a beautiful place. Heaven's going to be fun to be there. And so we thank you for the hope that lies within us. Would you be with this dear family, Lord? They're such a wonderful family, and I thank you for each one of them. I thank you for the friends that have been so loyal to Philip. And most of all, I thank you for Philip, Lord, who was easy to love, easy to like. And Father, I'm just so happy for him now that he has eternal bliss. In Jesus' precious and holy name, amen.
is it, in full military service. Played the taps. Pretty awesome. I got to speak at the funeral service, and several people congratulated me afterwards on it, even the driver of the limo, for the story that I told about Uncle Philip. And that was one that my grandma Zula gave me, was that boys cut up on their trip from Nebraska to here in a covered wagon to Barnett, Oklahoma. And the boys would cut up, his mother, Flora McCullough, would kick them out of the wagon and make them follow the wagon, which obviously had calves and the other animals that they were bringing with them, and kicking up quite a dust trail. And all the boys would, a couple of boys that was cutting up, would have to walk behind the wagon in that dust trail. Uncle Joe included. Uncle Victor would be with some of the older ones. Uncle Joe being, I guess, the baby, and Grandma being a baby. She was in diapers. And they talked about Uncle Philip playing skip-bo and some other stories. So it was a really warming service. And then they brought this outside here and then had the tap. So that topped off what is a wonderful service of a man that lived a wonderful life. He's given the ladies roses to lay on the casket. Poor Joe Trucker was able to come to Uncle Philip's funeral service, and I'm really glad I got to be able to make it, and that my company let me dispatch out here to Amarillo to a wonderful funeral service of my great Uncle Philip at the age of 88. The ones that didn't make it here to see this wonderful funeral service that we've had for Uncle Philip today. Everyone's fixing to leave. I'll get a ride back to my truck. I was surprised at how wonderful the service has turned out to be. It's a warm day out here, but just the sun is not overwhelming.
Yeah, I liked what you had to say, man.
Thank you.
And you did an interesting question, too.
Poor Joe Trucker, 62. P-O-R-J-O, Trucker, 62. On YouTube. I keep a diary of my travels on the big truck, going through Virginia and Wyoming and Utah. I was just out of Virginia. I've taken some pictures of course, Texas here and the grass situation. Of course, we have that there in Oklahoma. As well, lush green grass in Missouri and Arkansas. And, so,
you know, another thing about you, I noticed this is as a pastor, you enunciate your words great, you don't stutter or stammer. Have you done some public speaking?
No, but I am an alcoholic in recovery, 22 years, knock on wood, and so I do a lot of going to meetings and chatting with folks. And so this is just my way of giving back to my community and the things that, like my Uncle Philip has done. They do a family letter that the McCulloughs have been doing for nearly 8 years. And none of my Porter family has ever had the family reunion that I know of, except for my Grandma Zula, which was McCullough. And so they pass that family letter on, and it's still going around.
Well, you're easy to listen to, man.
Well, thank you. Thank you, sir. You heard it right from the preacher. He's the one that did the service. Awesome job. Joe Trucker.